Three, two, one. We are live.
Where the music? We ain't got no music today?
In your head.
The DJ Wody No Music Show.
This is a cappella.
Oh, man.
We got to fight the powers that be.
Oh, having some difficulties over here, man.
So we get it going.
Man, you got to do something, Walter. You got to go get a boom box, a clock radio, something. You just can't be without music. We don't care what you do, man. You going to get some music. Your kids going to have to sing. You responsible for the music, man. You can't be like, man, I got no music.
I'm about to go get my Alexa.
Oh, man.
Y'all start without me. I'll be here in a second.
Just groove to the beat in your head. We don't have any music on this episode.
Terrible.
All right. I need to get it together. I see Sister Soldier. She's grooving over there.
Cabbage Pat.
All right. Well, welcome to the 30-minute hour live on lockdown. This is where you unwind and unplug and let your hair down. We're coming at you today with the funny side, with the lighter side of social distancing. So I'm Eric Twiggs. I'm your procrastination prevention partner, but I'm not alone. Joining me as always is the super CEO, the business strategist extraordinaire, all around good guy, my right hand man, Ted Fells.
Get that Spike Lee going on.
Yeah, give us the Spike Lee effect.
Did that because Bill is not here today, so did the Spike Lee effect.
Yes.
Greetings, all.
All right. Greetings, all. F. William Samuel couldn't be with us today. Shout out to him. So that was our tribute to him with the Spike Lee effect. So also coming at you, we got the comedian Sister Soldier in the building.
Looking frozen. Oh, this is going to be a good one today.
I mean, but that's a good pose to be frozen in. That's a
good show. Oh my goodness. That's what happened when you use the modems. Yeah. Upgrade the internet.
Yeah, I think she on dial up or something. All right. And then back for his second week in a row, the comedian from the ATL, Kedar Whittle.
What's up, everybody? How y'all doing?
All right. All right, we got DJ Wody is in the building.
Don't give him no props yet, bro.
He gotta have some music.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know we're gonna let you down.
There you go.
Slide on a pimp gang with my pinky ring. Lot of gang, lot of just in the icy chain. While you claim that you rich, that's a false claim. I be straight to the whip, no baggage claim. Whole lot of styles, can't even pronounce the name. You ain't got no style, see you on my Instagram. I be rocking it like it's fresh out the pan. Only when I'm taking pics, I'm the middleman. Walk fucking.
All right. I'm ready. Let's get it, y'all.
All right. DJ Wody Rock is in the building. And also, we got the most popular participant on the 30-minute hour lockdown. Ask Gary. Gary Johnson himself is with us.
What's up?
The man who single-handedly lost all our sponsors last episode.
Single-handedly.
No,
like I said,
yes,
I can get them. I can get all new sponsors. Very interesting sponsors from all kinds of different industries.
Okay. All right.
We'll just have DEA and FBI following us with these new sponsors.
Oh no, they're all legit businesses. Manscaped, Banana Split, Entertainment, all kind of. I have a really, really good relationship with Pornhub. I run ads there all the time, so I can definitely get any of their entities. Doesn't matter which one, RedTube, any of them. I can definitely get a sponsorship from them.
Did you just say Pornhub?
Yeah, because the Traffic Junkie is where you go through to get the sponsorship. But yeah, it's Pornhub's ad network. So yeah, definitely.
Right. This is what I'm talking about.
But like Manscaped is a regular company, you know, regular company. Just
yeah.
For many different things. So yeah, plenty of sponsors available. I can get a Banana Split ad in a few minutes. Just give me.
Banana Split ad. Okay.
Yeah, if you want to sponsor for them, all I got to do is just send text and I read off something. They'll just send me a check. You know?
There you go. Yeah, I love it. Hey, y'all and I utilize Gary, right?
Okay.
Apparently we're not. Yeah, apparently we're not. So, you know, we talk, Gary inspired like a new kind of opening item here that I'm going to start tracking. So last week was just out of control. You know, for those of y'all that are watching this, you need to watch last week's episode. It was crazy. It was out of control. We were just dropping sponsors left and right. I mean, so I'm going to start giving you the sponsor drop update. I want you to know the sponsors that left us after watching us last week. I mean, we're lucky to still be on the air. You know, we're lucky the FCC is not coming after us. It was crazy. Last week, I mean, we lost First Baptist Church, Second Baptist Church, Third Baptist Church. Fourth Baptist is on the fence. Yeah. The pastor said he's going to check us out. Depending on how it goes today, he may drop off too.
You got to redeem yourself.
Yeah. Disney, Nickelodeon, just all gone. Rebe Jackson, she's hot with Bill. You know, all his comments.
Yeah, she just slinked on the way.
Slinked on the way. Yeah, like a centipede almost. All right. So hopefully we'll do better today. We'll keep it together and just won't lose everybody that's watching this.
Yeah.
Right. All right.
Don't blame it on me, though.
Don't blame it on you?
Nah.
Okay. All right. So let's get this party started. I know DJ Woody, he's got his music working now. So he's going to give us some Sister Soulja update, Sister Soulja perspective music.
Fight the power, Sister Soulja. Let's go.
Fight the power.
All right now. Thank you, DJ Wody, because I got a whole lot to say right now. First of all, made a little trip to the grocery store and saw a woman of lighter hue wearing a very interesting mask. She was wearing a sheer, bedazzled, I dream a genie thing across her face. Her mouth, not her nose, her mouth. And I had to stop and look and say, wait a minute, what is that? And what is that helping? Nothing. You look like a straight up I dream a genie fool. But I didn't say anything. I looked at her and I kept it moving. But it just told me some people just don't get it. Mm. Now, the other thing, I know my brothers are going to disagree, but summertime is really hot out here. Lady. Put some kind of clothes on. I know we've been locked down and I know you used to being free in the house, but at least put on some undergarments. Seriously. The only thing I want to be seeing. I'm just saying, I'm the voice of the woman on this show. And I'm just saying, I'm trying to see all that jiggling unless it's some jello. Hello. Now. Just fix your face. You got kids and you got enough of them, so just stop it. You don't need to be looking at them either.
Exactly why I need to look at them.
Now, finally, this is my other thing. I know we've all been teleworking hard, and I heard that, you know, the razor companies have lost a lot of money because the men are, you know, y'all stopped shaving and all that. But grooming, you know, the soap companies and deodorant companies are suffering too. So that tells me some of y'all are skipping the hygiene altogether. You still got to come out in public at some point. So again, people, the mask does not mask the funk. Please take heed and take care of your stuff before you come out and grab whatever you got to grab to go back in the house. Because we smell you. We smell you coming from a long way, a long distance. The air, the draft, and this heat, the humidity, all of that makes for bad, bad, bad breathing for us. I'm just saying. Now, the other thing I'm going to talk about is this happened to me on Friday. I'm sitting at the light to get off of the beltway here. In Georgia, it's kind of your light to get onto the beltway, you know, the traffic highway. And a brother runs into the back of me while I'm sitting still waiting for my light.
What?
Put my car in park. I get out to assess the damage, and he has ruined the bumper of my vehicle. So I said, wait a minute, I'm gonna have to get your information. Do you know when I went to go get my phone, that joker took off. Like, he did a George Jetson in the air, or he did a Fred Flintstone and picked that car up and ran, because I didn't even hear him accelerate. He was gone, y'all. It was a space between me and the truck that was behind him. I don't even know what direction he went, and he went so fast.
He was going he went to get his insurance information. He's coming
back. Right. Oh, hello. But how do you feel though? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. I'm just a little ticked off that I got duped like that. So I'm getting a dash cam for my car. Cause yeah, he got away. And now my
let me tell you the difference. Let me tell you the difference. One day I wanted to get someone's number and I said, hold on, let me get a pen. Do you know what a young person in my office said?
What?
You just put it in your phone. We so old that you said, I'm gonna have to get your information, and you turned around. You didn't pull out your phone. You should have took a picture of his license plate.
No, that's the problem. My phone was being charged in the car. So when I got out, I had to have undone my phone, not thinking that he was going to literally leave the scene.
Oh, you trust me. Oh, my God.
Yeah, because he's never lied to you before. I stepped out before. So that was,
So fight the power on that, people.
Yeah.
Get a dash cam. I'm just saying.
I'm glad you're better, though. I'm glad you didn't get hurt.
Thank you. I appreciate that because, I'm feeling some kind of way about that. I'm going to put his picture up in the post office.
Well, why would a total stranger with nothing to lose steer you wrong? I mean, this is crazy.
Okay.
Anybody else done ran off, though, on that accident?
I don't call it running off. I call it going to the next appointment. That's what I call it.
Really? Yeah, the next car you're going to hit.
I definitely ran off once.
Not recently.
Nah, I was in my 20s.
Okay.
I didn't feel like dealing with it, and it was my fault.
Yeah, so that's a place to be.
Right.
I went straight to the crib, bro.
That's probably where he went. I should have tried to find him.
So I thought the people was following me. Yeah, I was so paranoid. I was like, going along, I was dipping, going that one
but
way.
You understand.
I was in a movie. I was in a movie all by myself.
So that's all I have for right now, Eric. I'm just so done.
You're done. Okay.
I'm done.
Hey, Eric, we got an update from F. William Samuel.
Okay.
He said he's on a board call, but cheating and zooming with y'all too. And then he said he thinks that we lost 12th Baptist Church also. So, I mean, he must have got a call or something from Reverend Johnson. It's always a Reverend Johnson. Right. Reverend Johnson called him and told him, I heard that last week, and we out too. We out.
Yeah. I don't know what y'all doing. I'm trying to keep y'all on point. Y'all keep veering off to the left. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Nah, I mean, you're right. That's true. Ladies, keep your clothes on.
We might get some sponsors back without William here.
The sponsors. Ladies, put some clothes on.
Put some clothes on. Yeah. Put your clothes on.
Yeah, I for the record, I agree with Sister Soldier. Yeah. Not when
your wife is watching.
It's a big problem. All right. Hey, look, I'm just trying to stay out of trouble, right?
Right. That's it.
I'm just trying to keep my house straight.
Well, you know, Bill said, you know, he had a call or meeting or something today, but I really think it was all that talking about his wife's rice cooking last week.
Exactly. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Exactly.
He don't punish him. She might have pulled him.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. I think he got some grit
right now. He's sneaking.
He got some grit.
Hey, you know what you say? Down the basement somewhere.
Yeah, he down in the basement sneaking. He can't talk because then he'll give it away.
He want to do the East Orange, but he gonna be like this.
right. but he on punishment. I knew that. We knew that. We all knew he was gonna be on punishment.
Oh, it's going down.
Try to help him. Don't just stop. Stop.
Stop, bro.
Here's what happens. Like, your wife will never watch the podcast, but she'll watch that one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Watch that one.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah. So F William, yeah, we with you. Hopefully we'll see you next week.
Fight the brother, my brother. Fight the power.
Fight the power. So now it's time for the ATL update. I know we got some fresh ATL Kedar music.
Oh yeah. Cute. Y'all know. Oh, I got music too. Oh yeah, I forgot.
Let's go.
But Joe got that thing down. He know we got about 12 seconds before they snatch us. You know, he get it right there. Then he just mix up and just take off.
Right.
Good, man.
Nah, ATL, man, same thing. Corona's not here. It still ain't here. My boys' clubs still be packed. Like, still be packed. They went to they did send kids back to school on Monday, and there has already been a reported case. So one teacher, 20 kids got a quarantine. That thing gonna be shut down by Labor Day.
Yeah.
It'll be shut down by everybody going virtual by Labor Day.
Yeah.
Here's what you can't do. You cannot threaten. Yeah, everybody need to take heed to this. You cannot threaten an important Delta woman. Because she will go get all her sisters and do a protest down on that Capitol. They was down there singing hymns, praying. It was some petty prayers going out.
It don't matter.
Lord, I just pray Kemp get COVID. Let Kemp get it by himself just so he know how I feel, Lord. But they didn't go through with the lawsuit because them Delta, you can't threaten no black woman. You can't get a bunch of black women together that got a little power. What?
Okay.
I don't know what Kemp thought he was going to do, but Kemp dropped the lawsuit against Mayor Bottom, so that's what's up.
Hello.
That's it, man. Herman Cain, you know, rest in peace, Herman Cain. He always, you know, he lives in Atlanta, always go to the country club, you know, very nice guy. I don't wish death on nobody. And I don't think, no matter how I feel about you, I don't think death is the answer.
No.
But you can't gamble with your life at 70.
Nah.
You can't, bro. You can't be out there in no Tulsa, Oklahoma without no mask on taking photos, bro. Like, come on. Bro, you high risk. You over 70. That's high risk. You can't be out there. So rest in peace, Herman Cain. Yeah, that's it. That's it going on in Atlanta.
Come on. I'm glad you mentioned that thing about the clubs. because we've been having pool parties here at a mansion in Maryland.
Yeah. Yep.
And so yeah, they done wound that 100 people max back to 50. So yep. They said, okay, you take this. That yep. You couldn't do right with 100, now you're at 50.
Yeah. Man. Hey, y'all seen that kid that played for Orlando Magic that didn't wear a Black Lives Matter shirt?
Yeah.
And he didn't kneel when everybody else was kneeling.
That the one with the knee injury?
Blew his ACL out first quarter, baby. Get up out of here. Get him. Get him up out of here. Go. Get him up out of here. I'm talking about the ancestors said, what?
You must comply.
Bring him here.
Go get.
Hey, y'all run around and get that boy off out that court, huh?
Gone.
Have that ass up out of there quick.
You fit.
I hope he gets better. Will. You know what I'm saying? I heard he a local preacher. Or whatever. Hey, lean on the Lord. You're gonna lean on somebody.
Yeah, he fit.
Should have leaned when you had a chance.
He fitting to get it right. He gonna get it right.
Right, man. Hey, oh. That's it. Man, that's all I got.
I did see a post about the schools in Atlanta, and I saw kids just in a crowded hallway, just all on top of each other.
Yeah, mm-hmm. In the hallway. It ain't gonna happen.
No.
And the school you saw was a white school. It was like white school.
All right.
Hey, someone didn't even brush their teeth that morning, bro. It's
crazy. Showing the lady who's the superintendent of the school, you know, she's doing this press conference and they're like, she's like, oh no, schools are gonna open. That's our plan. We need the kids back in school. And they asked her, they're like, so what if there's an outbreak?
Right.
What do you do then? She's right. Like, man, I don't know.
We're gonna deal with that when we get there. We're gonna deal with that when we get there.
Don't ask
no questions. They don't know.
And the kids, they're resilient. They all right.
We didn't think that far ahead. No.
Right.
Yeah, we cross that bridge when we get there.
How's it going?
But for right now, they gonna go to school.
You guys to get
how's it gonna work? How's it gonna work with some little kids in school with masks on? That ain't lasting number about 7 minutes.
It won't.
It's hot. It's hot.
I can't breathe. Dare each other. I dare you to take your mask off. I dare you. Right.
Like I can't. My kids are 10 and 7. I can't keep my kids' mask on in the house with 4 of us.
Daddy, we trying to eat. Put the mask on.
Yeah, it ain't gonna happen.
Mask on.
They could be doing the I Dream a Genie thing.
It ain't gonna work.
Not happening.
That's wow. That's a setup for black fathers too.
That a setup.
So you know when your daddy come pick you up from school. Hey, boy, where your mask at, boy? And it's the third mask we done sent you with here this week. What man, you get? Hey, lose that mask one more time.
Look, but, hey,
it's like when they come around the corner without their jacket. Hey, where your jacket at?
A jacket I bought you.
Hey, get it. Go get it. I'll be right here. Go get it.
Nah, they're going to trade masks. I liked his Spider-Man mask.
Yep.
That's yours.
That's a mess. You went to school as Batman, you come back as Spider-Man. That's a problem.
It's gonna happen, man. It's gonna happen.
Oh man.
Change superheroes. It's crazy. All right, man. Well, thank you for that ATL update. Maybe one day the pandemic will get to Atlanta. I mean, it's interesting. It's everywhere except Atlanta.
Right.
No, they found $8 million in the bluff today of drug money.
Mm.
200 bricks, 1.5 million in cash.
They found it.
And I think it was a setup.
You think?
I think the wealthy business developer put that down there Let it find it. Now we got to break up all of this. Now we got to knock down all of these projects because the bluff is opportunity zone. And if you have a business on the opportunity zone, you don't pay no taxes on your profit.
Ooh.
Mm. Ain't no $8 million in the hood like that. Come on, man.
Nah. Who
owns 200 bricks in the hood? In the, that, and that's the hood hood.
Get out. Yeah.
Don't get we better wake up.
Truly.
These folks taking our neighborhoods right underneath us. I pass by Old Fourth Ward every day. It's a neighborhood in Atlanta. Man, I seen a trailer go up. Ain't nobody putting no trailer up there but a developer so he can come give these people their vouchers so they can get out. Now he about to take over the whole block. Bruh, they taking our hood from us, man.
Welcome to DC, buddy. We done been through a couple of them rounds.
That's crazy. My bad. I just thought about that and I just had to get that off my heart.
Thank you for sharing because it is the truth.
Yeah.
The truth. Yeah.
Right. Thank you for sharing there, Kedar. So next is, we have a comment from one of our faithful viewers. She says, how does Gary stay so still?
Two hits before he got on. Not Gary.
Yeah, there are a couple methods for that.
A couple of methods. I regret asking that question.
It's two methods. One, I have multiple screens, so I'm focused. I'm looking at one computer and then gazing at the other. So if I'm focused typing something, then I'm doing something in the background while the podcast is on. And then it's usually this one, this 1937 Jimi Hendrix Purple Haze Edition canvas. That one really gets me stuck. This one, not so much. This is a different one. It's called Black Mamba. It's more of a head high. It's about 70% THC. This is good for focus. This is really good for focus, but for stuckness, this creativity and stuckness, you want this.
You say stuckness.
Stuckness. A whole word. It's a whole word.
Stuckness. All right, couch lock. We're actually going to have an actual update from Gary. So, do we have any update music, DJ Wody, while we still have a sponsor?
Yup.
You know I had to come with this one for Gary. See, I'm riding high. Whoa, whoa. I let this breathe a little bit.
Player, give me some brew and I might just chill. But I'm the type that likes to light another joint like Cypress Hill. I still do these spit loogies when I puff on it. I got some bucks on it, but it ain't enough on it. Go get the ass, go get the ass.
That's for you, Gary.
All right, Gary.
Keto, I got 10 on it.
10, bro, I got.
All right, Gary, what you got?
Not too much. I mean, last week, pretty much been chilling. I said, you know, my normal financial market stuff, marketing stuff, lifting, doing the workout and everything like that. I've been not as heavy this week, mostly chilling this week, recovering. Cause since I'm getting back into powerlifting, I need a little bit more time to recover. So other than that, I've just been chilling, you know, still on my carnivore based diet, tons of meat. Mm-hmm. And that's it, just relaxing.
Yeah, I've been recovering too, Gary, since March.
From what?
Way too much lifting.
Too much power lifting, Sister Soldier.
Way too much, yeah.
So Gary, how much weight are you power lifting for that one?
Right now, luckily on the dumbbells, I'm choosing the dumbbells right now. It's about 45 pounds, which is pretty good for dumbbells each side. No barbells yet because I'm not going to a gym. So just on the dumbbell lifting, I'm at about 45 pounds each dumbbell.
Hmm. Wow. I
was thinking a lot more though for the power, you know, 45.
No, not for dumbbells because individual weight. So
yeah.
Okay. I was expecting you to say like 400 pounds or something.
No, that's like a barbell. That yeah, that's different because you have your whole body when it's separated, and you gotta split that.
Yeah.
One arm. Nah.
Yeah.
But you like doing that for real, for real. That's what's up, man.
Yeah.
That's kind of what I'm doing when I'm coming out Dollar Tree. I'm doing about 45 on each arm.
Hey, you
at Dollar Tree? I mean, that's like $1,000 at a Dollar Tree.
Okay. Yeah, that's a lot of Dollar Tree bags. Yeah. I take it in one lift.
Shoot, Dollar Tree should be a sponsor as much as we talk about Dollar Tree on there. We need to start going out after some spot. Look, a microwave pork rind.
Mm-hmm. Unopened.
My cholesterol just went up just looking at that bag. Exactly.
Wait, hold up. Sister Soldier, you ain't vegan?
What? No, man. Fight the power. No.
You ain't pescatarian or nothing? You ain't none of that?
No.
You don't got incense?
No. I am over 50 years old. I grew up on McDonald's. Nope.
You ain't got waist beads on? Oh, come on. You faking the phone.
That's the soul food soldier.
There you go. That's what that is.
Okay. Yeah.
Nah.
You know what's funny about this whole vegan thing, man? I be seeing a bunch of folk eating vegan this big.
Yeah. They gotta make up for that loss of meat.
I'm like, man, if I'm not gonna eat no meat, man, I need to be in some great shape. I can't be a big vegan.
But that's because they do. That's because they do what normal people do with regular food. They eat processed food.
Yeah.
So it don't break down.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you can't gain.
Eating clean. I was vegan meat. For a year. It ain't work. It
doesn't work like that.
Nah.
I was vegan for a whole year. Well, I had a dream about some chicken. Woke up next day, got Chick-fil-A. Never looked back.
That was it.
Never looked back, bro. I said, but I even missed the service at Chick-fil-A. Never looked back. Never said, dang, I missed my vegan days. No, I don't.
Well, Eric and I used to always talk about, man, a barbecue got to be the worst thing if you're vegan. Like, don't nobody want to put no asparagus on the grill, man. I want a rib or something, man.
Yeah.
I get that, but they'll tell you not. Give me a mushroom with some soy sauce and a mushroom. No. Give me a burger, bro.
And you know, the vegans, they always got to bring their own food.
Yeah.
Man, can you put this veggie patty on the grill? Hey, you want me to move these ribs to the side for that veggie patty? Man, you might have cooked that when you was at home and brought it with you.
Okay, here, look. Can you put this cheese on it, bro? That cheese don't even melt. You said cheese out here. Cheese don't even melt, bro.
Yes, some vegan cheese. What is that?
This shit don't melt.
Isn't that dairy? No, vegan cheese.
Nah.
You bring patties to the cookout. That's how you know you're serious about that thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Seriously.
Yeah.
And then they try to sit there and look like it's as good as what everybody else eating.
Right. Nah.
No, it's not.
No, it ain't good,
bro. Man, you eating hay. That is not good.
See, that reminds me back when I was on what's the name of that? Nutrisystem. And I used to carry my meals everywhere, and I had a burger. You add water to it and it just expand. That was before I got married. I ain't eating none of that no more.
Damn. Wait, like a Crystals or like a White Castle burger?
Nah, it was like their burger. I don't know what it's made of, but you add water, you put it in the microwave, and it comes big.
Damn.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. I don't know what that was.
Man, you was eating a chia burger. That thing started growing. chia burger. You don't want that. You know when y'all was growing up, all y'all wanted a chia pet, though. Yep. You looking up commercials, man.
Nah, Gary, I'm still trying to get me some of that bison stuff, though. I'm saving up to get that bison meat.
So Gary, are you still eating the bison?
Yeah, every here and there. I don't order as much, cause just to save a couple of some money. Cause now the Aldi's has really good meats. So I've been just getting a lot from Aldi's. So okay. I haven't been ordering boxes of bison, cause it's inconvenient, cause they ship it Monday, it'll get here Wednesday if you're lucky. So you got to wait a while. You have to plan around that kind of shipment. So luckily I found that Aldi's has a really, really good selection of various kinds of meats. So I've been using them a lot.
Okay, I got to check.
So have you seen the difference in your shape since you've been lifting?
Oh yeah, definitely. Big time. Because when I wasn't lifting, you know, I had more of a runner's body. So now I'm just putting on muscle inside, you know, getting the typical V shape from the work, because I'm doing all compound exercises, you know, just your basic, you know, squats, overhead presses, rowing.
Yeah, I still have the H shape.
He's in the H shape.
I'm not at a V. I'm still at an H.
Well, you don't want to be at a V. That's more of a male physique.
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. I'm going to stick with my H. Hello.
Right. Well, Gary, once again, we done learned something about you. We learn something different every week about you, Gary.
Yeah, I'll never forget when Gary was saying, when he first started talking to us about the bison and stuff. Then you said that you had like you had your cow. It was almost like you treated like a horse. Like you go visit it and you see it and you know, get to know it. And that's gotta suck though, man. They sitting there, they thinking they happy to see you all the time. You just watching them just get, you know, media, and then one day
friendship. We're gonna be one.
But Ted, at that time, we didn't know Gary was on that Black Mamba. Had we known?
Yeah,
that's the way to do it. That's how you get the healthiest meat, you know, single cow, single bison, farm raised.
Okay, I'm gonna be like you one day, Gary. I'm gonna get that money so I can do that.
I mean, that's the way to go, because even if you don't get the whole cow, if you were to go out and hunt and kill one deer, that can last you almost a year. That's a lot of meat.
Wait a minute, they've been running in my backyard for a minute. Oh, I need to
get some. Yeah, we can.
Oh, man, ain't nobody eating on no deer for a whole year, bro. Black folks don't like leftovers like that.
I gotta give me a
leftovers for a year, bro.
You mean deer cuts?
Man, that meat ain't fresh.
Is that a deer cut sub you eat?
Yeah, we be so tired of that turkey round Thanksgiving. You talking about a whole year?
Yeah, kill it, chop it up, put it in the freezer, salt, man, pepper. That's all you need.
Oh man,
I don't want to see nobody with somebody can have a Caesar salad with deer.
Hey, bro, hey, put them deer ribs on there. Put them deer ribs up.
Give me a deer chop.
Yeah, a lot of people underestimate how much food, because even if I were to let a wolf, you know, a pack of wolves or a lion kill it, the leftovers from the deer is enough for 4 Big Macs. You can scavenge that stuff right up. Man.
Oh, so now I'm done. I just lost my taste.
Can you imagine? You got people over, you got this salad. They're like, oh, yeah, okay, what's this? Is this grilled chicken? Oh, no, that's deer.
That's deer.
Yeah, can't trick me like that, man.
Ew.
It don't taste like chicken, because it don't taste like chicken.
No, it doesn't.
It tastes like gamey meat.
Yeah.
It needs some pepper. Nice. It needs some help.
I feel like you eat some deer meat, you just want to start running.
I swear, I did it in New York. I did it in New York. It was some deer meat on sale, and I only had a couple of dollars, and I said, you know what, I'm going to go for it. It looked like regular beef.
Yeah.
And I made some burgers, and I bit into it and was mad. I was so mad. Because I was broke. Some days I had to choose between breakfast or dinner the next day.
Yeah.
And I made the decision of dinner the next day.
Wow.
Wow.
And it was venison, burgers. Ugh. I was so mad, bro. I threw it.
That means you really
out the house. I hope a homeless man get it in. And he enjoys it because this shit is trash.
Yeah, I don't eat a lot of venison, but even for just for comparison, if we have a full cow, how much meat that actually is?
Yeah.
We could do some things with that. We could throw them ribs on.
Right. Well, if you're doing that though, Gary, you got to have a deep freezer. You can't just put that.
Yeah, definitely. No, it won't fit. Yeah, you need a deep freeze for sure.
Wow. Okay, I'm gonna look at these deer a little bit differently now.
Yeah. Hey, but that's how you do it though. You get a couple family members or a couple of neighbors, and y'all go to a local farm, get your fresh chicken, your fresh eggs, your fresh meat. You can get a whole, like you were saying, get a whole cow, get it cut up, spread it out between the three families.
Mm-hmm.
That's how you really do it. That's how ultimately I want to live. I want to live off my own land ultimately.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. That'd be great.
I still gotta buy a couple Rolls Royces and trick off some money first. But then, first, after that, right.
Then I get serious about life a little bit. Then we living off the land, bro.
After you get the Rolls Royce. All right.
Priorities.
So it's time. It's time for the DJ Wody. DJ Wody update.
We had a great night on Friday night. Great night, great night. Had four DJs, four all-star DJs in the house with me. Well, four including me, of course. the Zoom party, man, it's crazy. We had the whole screen full. We had about 20 cameras showing, about 10 not showing, you know, in the dark. But it was great. Let's see. I had my first issue, though, this week with the DJs. Because usually we all love each other and love on each other, and everybody play, everybody, we pumping up each other in the background. But I invited a new DJ this week, and he was going. I mean, he was off the chain. He was going hard. But we like, it's been 20 minutes. Wait a minute, it's been 30 minutes. And we're like, hey, there's some more DJs here.
Wow.
So we had to give
him the light.
We had to give him the hook, and he didn't like it. And, you know, he was like, man, I'm going, man. I can't play all my music. You know, I got too many songs. I got 50,000 songs. I'm like, brother, we got like three more DJs ready to play behind you. So,
right.
Bye.
You know, one DJ said, man, you know, I'm done. He done played all the songs. I can't play.
Wasn't nothing left.
Dang.
I'm realizing now that I actually have to be a coach in this thing. I got to be like, okay, bro, you out. Yeah, you get in the game.
Right.
You're right. Going for 55, you know, and everybody else is getting 12, 20 points on the
right.
Pitch. So that was my first issue, and but I handled that. Everybody's good.
Yeah.
And my next thing is, you know, we start at 11 p.m. Eastern. You know, Kedar hitting the kids in the bed, and I be having cats fall asleep on camera. You know what I'm saying? Now I'm part of that problem because, you know, not that I urge people to drink, but we do have a party atmosphere going on. So he went a little too hard in the paint with the alcohol and passed out on camera, and as I'm trying to wake him up,
oh no,
he's struggling trying to wake up, but he just can't.
He can't do it.
He's done. So
wow.
Between the DJ battles and the sleeping, the Zoom party though, still off the chain. Still the best.
The problem is he started drinking at 8:45.
That's what happened.
Trying to say, you say, you know what? I'm gonna fix me one. I'm gonna fix me one and wait for the party to start.
that is true.
I'm gonna tell you, I was at the party and the party was hot, man. And you just the problem that you do, you know, you be sitting on the couch and you just start leaning and you try to get because you know people. Because see, one of the things that Joe will do to you, man, is he'll put you on spotlight.
Right. Oh.
Yeah, and so you got to catch yourself. You'll see yourself big on the screen, and you better start doing something like you was dancing.
Yeah.
Because if you was in there sleeping, them jokers see you, man. So, yeah, you need to be looking at that screen, man, because if he put you on the spotlight, everybody looking at you and it's being recorded.
Wow. I'm going to take a nap so I can join this Friday.
Oh, that's not true either. You take a nap, you sleep for the rest of the night. What are you talking about?
Oh, right.
You're going to take a nap on Thursday for Friday. That ain't going to work.
I take power naps, okay? I know me. Thank you.
Not at 8 o'clock?
No, not at 8. I got to do it early in the day so I can get up for 11.
But, you know, everybody else was on there. You know, they was on there having their drinks and watching. And, I just did something different. I went and got me a bowl of ice cream. And I did this, though. because how you gonna look, you know, sitting there with, you know, with some ice cream or whatever, yeah, everybody else, you know, like got their drinks, you know, they mixing drinks, and I got a bowl of.
Yeah, you was like sitting off way in the back on your couch.
Yeah. Cause you get a little sleepy too, man. I have ice cream. You know, you start getting hungry, man. Pretzels, start getting the munchies. Y'all doing all this drinking, I want a snack.
Mama's boy needed his milk before bed.
Who you telling, man? Dad?
I was kind of pressed. I was like, man, I had it in my calendar. I'm like, man, I got to get home. I was already home. So I had to get home. I was already home. I felt like, what am I going to put on? Right? Because you be thinking, what you going to wear?
Oh,
right. I didn't wear what I had on all day. You know, because folks be on there with the cowboy hats. I mean, they be doing it, man. Not that I'm going to put a cowboy hat on. But, I mean, folks be in there, they really be, yeah.
They get, yeah.
People who refuse to wear the same thing every time. They got something new on.
Right. Well, I would hope so. Yeah, change your clothes. Take a bath and change your clothes.
I'm sure they got the same.
We're going to catch on if you're wearing the same thing every week.
Yeah. Right. Oh, yeah.
You got to mix that thing up. Yeah.
Yeah. You can't do it at the Zoom party. I mean, you got to dress up. I mean, they be doing it, though. They have makeup and stuff on. I mean, they be look like they're really going out.
Okay.
Good thing about it, you really got to do just roll upstairs after they log off.
There you go. All right. I'm going to do it this week.
Yeah, check it out.
Yeah,
is this going to be the way the keto is going to join us?
No.
He ain't even going to fake it. Nah.
Keto waiting for the day party. Tell him, Keto.
Hey, I got you. Where the day party at?
We might do a Saturday day party, though. That's a good idea, right?
Yeah, do a day party, man.
I'm full of them. I'm full of them. Good ideas. I'm full of
them. Yep. Where else we going?
You know, my wife would say if I tried to turn on a party at 11 o'clock at night, bro.
Look, my wife had one issue with me being at home for a party. She's like, oh, you going to the party? I'm like, yep. Well, you got shorts on. I'm like, I'm just going downstairs. Same drawers on, too. Oh, yeah.
That's the safe party. Keep my eye on you.
Hey, so DJ Wody, I was looking through the comments when I was, your thing was off the chain. There was a lot of requests for Atomic Dog.
I saw one.
Really?
One request for Atomic Dog.
I'm just telling you what the people want. You know what I'm saying? I'm a messenger for the people.
Hey, you got it. Yeah, and hey, look, when they request for Atomic Dog, you got to give it to them because.
Hey, yeah, you know.
You know the cues. They do honorary stuff now.
You know.
Oh man,
they got he a Q now. He a Q. You know he signed up. Yeah, yeah. George Clint signed up.
Get to her. Get to her.
I see Eric.
Yeah. Oh.
That's you.
Oh.
Now you know what. So back in the day, man, I'll be jumping all up and down. But now, this is all I got. That's it.
Just the start of it.
If we somewhere and you see the guys that went over last year just jumping all over the place, you're going to see Bill and I. We're going to be just like this. That's all we got.
Hey, Twigs, how tall are you?
5'11".
Oh, that's not bad. Mm-hmm.
Oh my goodness, man. If you'd have said 5'9", he'd have been, oh man, you gonna say that was bad?
Yeah, I don't know if anybody else 5'9", but I would have. I thought you were shorter. That's why I asked.
Okay.
I'm trying to picture you younger doing hopping.
Yeah. Back in the day, but now it's a little different now. But now,
how do you feel about having some new frat brothers?
Well, it's good to add to the membership, you know. You gotta add to the membership. I think they're gonna represent.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I've heard good things from people that have met them and interacted with them. So, yep.
Nah, that's what's up, man.
Yeah.
They just be giving it away, huh?
You know what? He's trying to get you a hot water.
I know. I see where he's trying to go with
don't
this.
Don't go there.
He's going to be giving it away. Hey, who? Oh, yeah. Come on, bro. I got you. Come on.
So I take it that this is the 30-minute Kappa hour now. So you got that honorary.
You see. Let me see. It says 1911, but I can't.
Oh Lord!
No, this is the Kappa version. It's the Noop inspired version.
Wow! Like, oh my.
Y'all are Trump supporters. That's cool.
So Eric, is it time for the virtual update?
Yeah, it's about that time. It's about that time. Yeah. So we got a new segment. It's called the Homeschool Virtual Update. And not only is Kedar a comedian, but he's also an educational expert.
Oh.
So we'll let him be like he just found out about that.
Yeah. No surprise.
Now, really? let's hear the homeschool virtual update.
Everybody going virtual.
Mm-hmm.
Or they will be going virtual. Now, parents, please, there's plenty of companies out there. Get some support. Have somebody come to the house, which is a lot safer than your child going out to hundreds. Have somebody come to the house, help your kids, because you can't. You can't help your kids how your kids need to be helped. So get somebody to come to the house to help make sure your kids just paper turned in. You don't know how to turn on that iPad either. Your kid don't know how to turn on that iPad and flip through. You don't know how to do it. Get somebody to come to the house that know what they're doing. Your kids are frustrated, parents. Every parent, your kids are frustrated. They don't want to do this virtual stuff no more. Like, y'all don't want to do virtual stuff no more. Why you think your kids want to do it? You don't want to be at the house. You want to be out and about, rocking your afro like Sister Soldier. But don't shake too hard, baby. Don't shake too hard. But your kids don't want to do it either. Just know that. Don't yell at them every time. You know what I'm saying? Like, just know they going through some stuff too. They miss their friends. Mm-hmm. Some girls got, like, boys and little girls, their hormones are coming on, but they ain't got nobody to release them on but at the house. So just be thinking about all that stuff, parents. Don't choke nobody out. Don't choke nobody. We in the home stretch. All this will be over by January.
How much this gonna cost?
Huh?
How much is this gonna cost me? To have somebody come and relieve me of all this stress.
So my company, we do it. TutorsOnDemandLLC.com. We are deploying teachers into homes. We got plans as low as $10 an hour.
What?
Absolutely.
I know some adults that we might need to send some teachers to, because that some way some of the people writing and stuff. So I'm gonna see. I might have you help some people out.
Bro, it was a show. Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader for a Reason?
Yeah.
Like
a whole show.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that's like parents, just really be there for your kids. Because mm-hmm. y'all don't know what y'all doing. Kids don't know what they doing. Don't nobody know what we doing right now, because we ain't never been through this before.
Nope.
But I know people just about tired of computers though. You know, kids that went through the virtual school and mm-hmm. then, you know, like my fraternity, they do this camping thing every year. They did it virtually.
How you
I mean, you're doing a campfire in the house. Like, how are you doing that?
Nah, that's big.
Like, hey, I got a money play for y'all. If y'all know anybody that can get those UV, like those ultraviolet rays glasses that protect your eyes from looking at the screens,
I'm sure
we can sell them to school districts.
Gary,
yeah.
I'm sure Gary got
to hook up
with that. Look,
yeah, Gary got
a
hook up.
I'm sure I can find them, like blue blockers or something like that.
Because you got it, like you got to protect these children too.
Yep. Yeah.
We can get some like cheap ones. How they have like at the
movie
theater.
Uh huh.
Well, yeah, there's a lot of people in tech using
money, but that's a money play. It ain't a big money play, depending on how many school districts you can get, but it's a money play.
So, in honor of F. Williams, that's how you win right there. That sounds like a winner.
That's how you win.
Yeah.
That's how you win.
Can you explain something to me? I'm going to ask you this as a parent. Like, I know what the parent's role is, which apparently is everything. You know, mm-hmm. lesson you do.
Yep.
What is the teacher supposed to do in this whole equation of the homeschooling piece? What is the ideal teacher role? I'm just curious.
Now, teachers are going to be burnt out.
Yeah.
They're going to be burnt out because they got to do multiple facets of learning because mm-hmm. every child learns differently. So yeah. they have to do the small groups. They yeah. have to do the one-on-one. They have to record videos daily just to keep their kids engaged. Mm-hmm. They got to then be the counselor because they got to call the people in the parents like, hey, your kid ain't logging on. And they got to figure out how to be the technology person because you got to teach a kid and a parent how to get on. These teachers going to be burnt, bruh. We going to lose some teachers to this.
That's why I left the classroom 25 years ago because I had to do all that, but in person.
We going to lose. If we don't give these teachers a raise, we going to lose a bunch of teachers with this.
Okay. For real.
You asking these teachers to go face to face and you ain't giving them hazard pay? They ain't no frontline worker.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's like, why we're not,
hey, look, man, I sign as an educator, you sign your life up to make the world better.
Yep.
I ain't signed my life up to die for it. I could have went to the army for that.
There you go. That's how Sister Soldier was born.
I was in the classroom, bruh.
Battle. Yes.
Yeah, it's crazy, man. You ain't paying these teachers no hazard pay, and you want them to go teach these kids that don't even know how to even wash their ass? Ain't nobody wearing no mask. Kids don't, why don't kids don't brush their teeth? What you mean they gonna be, yeah. It's crazy, man.
Oh, man.
Erica, it sounds like it's time for you doing too much.
Yeah. doing too much.
Look, I got a good one for you. So I pull up into my driveway today and my neighbor tells me or asks me, can you move your car from in front of your house because it looks like it's leaking gas. First of all, I don't live in a neighborhood that has an HOA. Secondly, you have not been designated as the person to enforce anything. And thirdly, you need to mind your business because we don't have an HOA. So the non-HOA enforcement neighbor, get out my face. You doing way too much.
Way too much.
Like everybody has that neighbor.
Okay.
It's like they deputize themselves as like the neighborhood watch person. It's like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't get.
And where she wants you to put the car at?
I guess in my two-car garage that we all know you can only get one car in. So mind your business.
Doing too much.
Doing too much. Get that leaky oil car off that street. Put that jalopy in there, girl.
messing up the cul-de-sac.
Trying to bring some value to the house. She right. She trying to bring value to the neighborhood. You got to
go.
Got your who ride outside. Messing
that's
up
right. It's mine.
Or the driveway.
What's it ain't. She driveway? Ain't moved. That car ain't moved in a year and a half.
Okay, but it's my car in front of my house. Mine's a business.
Y'all ain't got no plans to make it move.
Nope.
All right, so I got one for you doing too much. This is a sign I saw. You know, this business, they're doing too much. I mean, they're getting too serious about this pandemic protection and everything else. So I'm going in, they're like, I see the sign. The sign says, if you come without a mask, you come in here without a mask, we have to take your temperature. But we only have rectal thermometers.
No!
Love it.
Man, let me tell you. No way. I was like this. Let me make sure I got my mask on.
I love it.
You put two masks on.
Right?
I love it.
Oh, no.
I'm going to tell you, man, you're doing too much. I went today to get my car service today, and my service attendant, Tammy, I'm not going to say her name, who I've worked with for years.
She said to me when I got to, she said, "Yeah, I've been watching y'all the show and everything, and it's really good and all that." And I was like, "Okay, I wouldn't sit down." And then she came to me with the bill and said it's $2,800.
Ooh.
Now that's charging too much.
That's way too much.
$2,800. You know, I shared that with another friend, and I said $2,800. She said dollars. I said no cents. I mean, $2,800. But here's the worst part. So they gave me a loaner, and they gave me this little red card. This all we have. Little red card, right? I'm getting up in here. I'm feeling like like an M&M. The card's red. I'm chocolate. I'm in the little car, and you can't look hard in that little car.
Nah.
You can't play nothing on the radio. Like, what you gonna play? Like, you can't play no hip hop. I can't play none of Wody stuff. I can't play no go-go. I can't play no R&B. I can't play nothing. You just gotta just drive. And people, they riding by you in their trucks and stuff, and they just looking down at you. Look at him in that little car.
You got a clown car.
They won't even let you in or anything in the lane because you're in that little car. You wait. You can't look hard in a little car.
You can't even park that car on the front of your house.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. I don't want to get no gas in it. Nothing. They were doing entirely too much. And then I was talking to another friend of mine today. She's talking about this steak and cheese spot. Matter of fact, Cindy, who was on the show with us before from ATL, she was in town. She said, yeah, she went to steak this spot called The Broiler. Went and got her steak and cheese and a small pizza. Now I said, wait a second. A small pizza is not a side dish. Like you don't get like a steak and cheese and a side of pizza. You get a side of salad or something. You get a side of pizza. You're doing too much with a steak and cheese and a small pizza.
Oh yeah.
Too much.
She hit that Black Mamba. You didn't even know it.
Right. Snacking.
He's hanging out with Gary. Man. All right. That is our time.
Oh gosh.
This week. I think we dropped about four or five more sponsors.
It's y'all fault. It's your fault. I'm trying to help y'all.
Nah, man. They
voting Sister Soulja out the neighborhood.
Yeah, right.
Over there, you out.
They're gonna have to drag me out of here.
She didn't know she had an HOA.
No, I don't.
Right. Just because you ain't been paying the fee don't mean y'all, we ain't got no HOA. Because you've been thinking this junk mail all this time.
Right.
You probably owe about $27,000 to put on the fees. HOA.
They coming for you. I want to be in debt to the HOA. All right.
Oh, right.
How can people
gonna start? Hey, she gonna start one, and you're gonna be the first person she get at too. All right, man, I gotta go. I'm 4 minutes past my
Hey, tell everybody how they can connect with you before you drop off.
Hey, hit me at Kedar, KEEDAR on all social media. Check out my companies though, Educators Now LLC and at Tutors on Demand LLC and at WeMadeAmericaGreat.us.
All right. Cool.
And I think we get one cuss word per episode. Kedar,
I got an idea too, so I'll be good for next episode too.
Good grief. Bye.
All right, I appreciate y'all.
All right, man. Hey, Sister Soldier, how can the people connect with you?
Hey, check out on Instagram, Christine the Comedian, and all other social media is sistersoldier.now.site. SITE. Fight the power, y'all.
Fight the power. Fight the HOA. All right.
Yes.
Gary, how can the people connect with you?
You can go to ysnake.live or just type ysnake into Google and whatever your favorite social media platform will pop up and you'll find the purple snake and you'll find me.
All right. I tell you, I just learn more and more about Gary every week, man. It's,
oh my goodness,
it's an educational experience.
Everybody need a friend. Everybody need a friend like Gary, though. I'm telling you. For years, man, I've been looking for a friend like you, Gary. I just feel like more knowledgeable. I just feel cool. I feel connected. Even though we got probably a 30-year age difference, man, you like one of my best friends right now, Gary. I'm just letting folks know. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to hang out with you virtually, all that, man. When this thing open up, man, you and I are going to hang out. We're going to be hitting some spots. Tell your friends, this is platinum. This is not gray. I'm going to be hanging out with you.
You got to smoke that Mamba, though.
Oh, I can't do that. I can't do that.
All right. DJ Wody, how can the people connect with you?
Look, man, yeah. Every Friday and Monday night. Everybody get your body, get your roll on. I don't show you, she doesn't want to show song. Had a man. I'll be on Zoom 562-565-8799. Log in 11 p.m. on Friday night at Wody Rock.
Joe, we're gonna have to put it out there, man, so people can see the number, man, so they can come, cause yeah, it's the hottest virtual party out there on Friday nights, man.
Hottest in the DMV in Nashville.
Absolutely. Yeah. DMV and Nashville and everything in between.
Right.
All right, and you can check Ted and I out on the 30 Minute Hour podcast Mondays at 7 o'clock. You can also go to the What Now Movement group on Facebook and check us out there. Every day we got a different video coming at you to inspire you to take your game to the next level. That's our show for this week. Until next time, have a great one.